Welcome back, Machine Learning Time. Previously on Epic Society, in machine learning, we looked at the basics of machine learning and the difference between supervised and unsupervised learning. Today, I propose to dive into one of the first notions that deals with classification and pre-processing. First and foremost, classification. What is it? The process of classification is one such technique where we classify data into a given number of classes. During classification, we arrange data into a fixed number of categories so that it can be used most effectively and efficiently. In machine learning, classification solves the problem of predicting the categories of a given data point. We build the classification model based on training data set containing data points and the corresponding labels. For example, spam detection in email service providers can be identified as a classification problem. This is a binary classification since there are only two classes, spam and non-spam. A classifier utilizes some training data to understand how given variables relate to the class. In this case, non-spam and non-spam emails have to be used as the training data. When the classifier is trained accurately, it can be used to detect an unknown email. Pre-processing refers to the transformations applied to our data before feeding it to an algorithm. Data processing is a technique that is used to convert the raw data into a clean data set. In other words, whenever the data is gathered from different sources, it is collected in a raw format which is not feasible for the analysis. Well, why do we need to pre-process our data? In order to achieve a better result in a machine learning project, the format of a data has to be in a proper manner. Some specified machine learning models need information in a specific format. For example, random forest algorithm does not support null values. Therefore, to execute a random forest algorithm's null values have to be managed from the original raw dataset, and the best out of them is chosen. Another aspect is that dataset should be formatted in such a way that more than one machine learning and deep learning algorithms are executed in one dataset, and best out of them is chosen as well. Now, let's see how to do this. First, open your IDE. It can be Sublime Text, Python, VS Code, or any IDE you like. I prefer Atom for this task. To learn how to download and install Atom, link in the description. I will create a new folder and name it Machine Learning like that. Select the folder, right-click and create a new Python file with the name. Choose any name you like. Import NumPy as np. Since our sklearn, we're going to import now pre-processing. We can define some sample data to work with right here. We will be talking about several pre-processing techniques. Binarization. This process is used when we want to convert our numerical value into a Boolean value, let's say true or false, you know. print. And run the code. One or two from programming logic is binary. It can also be seen as true or false. You will see these values. And we all see here, all the values that are more than 2.1 become 1 and the remaining 1 become 0. Let's look at mean removal. Removing the mean is a common pre-processing technique used in machine learning. It is usually useful to remove the mean of our feature vector so that each feature is centered at on zero. We do this in order to remove bias from the features in our feature vector. Follow along by doing this. We will display the mean and the standard deviation first by writing this code. Let's run and see if it truly prints. Yeah. Let's come again to our IDE. This code will allow us to remove the mean. If you run the code, you will see this detail printed on your terminal. As seen from the value obtained, the mean value is pretty close to zero and the standard deviation is 1. In our feature vector, the value of each feature vector can vary around many random values. So it becomes important to scale those features so that it is a level playing field for the machine learning algorithm to train on it. We don't want any feature to be artificially large or small because of the nature of measurement. Add this to the Python code. By running the code, we see in the terminal. Each row is scaled so that the maximum value is 1 and all the other values are relative to the maximum. Now, normalization. We use the process of normalization to modify the value in the feature vector so that we can measure them on a common scale. In machine learning, we use many different forms of normalization. Some of the most common forms of normalization aim to modify the values so that they sum up to 1. For example, L1 normalization, which refers to least absolute deviation, works by making sure that the sum of absolute value is 1. Then, L2 normalization refers to least square, works by making sure that the sum of square is 1. In general, L1 normalization is considered more robust than L2 due to resistance to outliers. A lot of time, data tends to contain outliers and we cannot do anything about it. We want to use techniques that can safely and effectively ignore them during the calculations. If we are solving the problem where outliers are important, then maybe L2 will be the best choice. If we run the code, you will see the normalized data printed here. Cool! We pre-processed the data in this video. It was machine learning with Sol, and I will see you in the next video.